Gruff Delegate says, "Damn it! Now we'll never get an answer out of her. Not unless I read her soul." They pull your names up. I like that. Let's just read her soul. I'm afraid if I don't do it now, I might not get a chance later in dialogue. You reach out and brace against a sudden flare of pain and fear. Digging after less recent events, there's a copper taste in your mouth and pain like fire in your throat. Under the brute terror of death, you find a comforting thread of resolve, of satisfaction in duty fulfilled. You follow it. It leads you stumbling into another memory, as whole and vivid as the first. You walk the dark halls of an abbey, dimly lit and quiet, your footsteps loud. A blur, and you are standing in a dimly lit room, facing a robed Amawa. You recognize him as Kyoto, the High Abbot. He beckons you forward. Before I step forward, let me examine the surroundings. You are in a wide, rounded chamber. The titles beneath your feet are covered in strange, curling symbols. You recognize them as symbols of Andra, goddess of sea and memory. The memory blurs. When your sight is clear, you are standing in front of Kyoto, and he is smiling gently down upon you. Well, I guess I took that step forward anyway.
Drive the raid series from these mountains, and you may yet spare many lives. The Tidebringer will be here in a week's time. Should you be delayed in your travels, report to him as you would to me. He will enter the reliquary and call off the army of Eyeless in my stead.
The army of Eyeless. The Tidebringer. The reliquary, whatever you say.
If you are caught, sister, you know what you must do. I will pray for your return, but we will take comfort in the knowledge that you have joined the rest of Andra's favorite in her keeping.
Is this... Do they follow Andra? These people? And this Eyeless army? The words jar you loose from the memory, flinging you back into the moment of the woman's death, and then into your own skin. But traces of her memory join yours. You know the path to the abbey to which she was to return, buried in the mountains to the north. Is the name Eyeless familiar to anyone? Gruff Delegate says, "The Eyeless? They're a figure of speech for when you can't remember something. You say, must be the Eyeless took it from me." The frightened delegate says, "Yes, yes, but there's a story to it. They're supposed to do the bidding of the Lady of Lament." Is that Andra? Yeah, Andra points and they come. Out of nowhere. Wipe things from the face of the world. That's why whenever something up and goes missing, or gets destroyed with no one there to see it, you're supposed to thank Andra that the Eyeless didn't come for you, too. Do you know a Kyoto? The Gruff Delegate says, "Kyoto? Oh, yes. He came through town some time back. Stopped by at the temple in Stalwart. This was just after the town decided to rededicate it to Abaddon." Just after. He didn't seem too pleased about it. He was dressed like a priest. Maybe he took offense. He's an Amawa, tall fellow, very polite, considering he's apparently the leader of some fanatical sect. Dwarven Delegate says, "I think it's clear we haven't been the best judges of character recently." Do any of you know what a Tidebringer is? The Dwarven Delegate says, "Tidebringer? That's something they used to talk about at the Temple of Andra, I think. It's a person. A title, I mean. Tends to be used in the more, devout circles." This is a different question about the Eyeless, but I'm willing to bet at least the same answers, but just in case. Yeah. Do you know anything about an abbey to the north? The dwarf says, I've heard of something like that. An Andrite stronghold. Not the kind of place that welcomes visitors. Was that the place that Maneha's looking for? Maneha's eyes widen. That sounds like the Abbey of the Fallen Moon. Is that where she came from? The gruff delegate points to the dead woman. Yes. And it's where I'll find the reliquary so I can call off their army. The gruff delegate says, What? Another one? Gods, it feels like everyone on Ayura is after the battery now. Why would these Andrites want the Ritzerans out? I doubt it's for Stalwart's benefit. Competition, maybe? Looks like I've fouled up their plans in any case. The dwarf says, If you do mean to go to this abbey, be careful. There have been stories about traitors wandering north and getting scared off or even killed by strange guards. Maneha says, That's the place, all right. The gruff delegate says, They're a secretive bunch. I suppose you could always try to sneak in? I doubt you'd be welcome, otherwise. The frightened one says, It sounds like this Tidebringer would be welcome, I mean. Sneaking around is my style. Maybe I can convince them I'm the one they've been waiting for. The dwarf says, I hope so. I imagine the abbey is heavily guard. A sudden, deafening crash from outside makes the delegate jump, startled. A rumbling like thunder follows. You hear further sounds of smashing timbers, panic screaming. The frightened delegate is even more frightened, right? Oh no, what's happening? I thought you took care of the soldiers. I did. This is something else. Yes, well, we'll wait here, inside. Sheesh. Investigate the commotion. It turns out that one of the delegates sabotaged the negotiations. She took her own life before she could be questioned in the usual way. From her memories, I have gleaned knowledge of the temple complex she was sent from. Any further investigation will have to wait. I've been interrupted by the sounds of conflict just outside. It sounds like something very, very heavy. Well, there's a dagger she's put into her body. Some silver. Maybe it's nothing. Please be careful. All right. Let's go see what huge frickin' giants are pounding around outside. Oh my. Survive the ambush. Oh crap. Enter scouting in combat.
Oh, are those things here for us or...
or what? Immune to blinded, charmed, confused, diseased, dominated, poisoned, sickened, and unconscious. You can at least start us off with just one of these things. Okay. Punch it then. Let's hope we survive this. I have no idea how tough these things are. They are nasty friggin' things. Well, combat's underway even though we have no music. Somehow that makes it even more creepy. So what have I chose? Killing Bolt.
For the Iron Flail.
Doing damage? A crit is 24. Alright. Let's show these freaking things how we do things downtown. Yeah, injured. We can't dominate them. Maybe we can detonate it. Did that do any damage? It did. Oh! The freezing rake hit a dare. Damn it. It didn't hit these guys at all? Let's not damage our own? I don't know. Killing Bolt again. Looking, because he's really getting damaged here. I'm hoping crap isn't reflecting back on him. Alright, we need, in any case, we need more healing for him. I think they're immune to... Well, supposedly, they're not immune to frightened? Blinded, charm, confused, disease, dominated, poison. I don't know if it'll do any good, but... Did that work? They're both on there. They both got knocked down. Another killing bolt, badly injured. Oh my god. Eyeless hammer knocked out of air. Did you cast that yet? She needs to run forward. You can attack this thing. Go this way. Go this way. This is our last critical. Raising pillar. Crap. We need better healing spells. Is he, like, standing up at this point? We're still working on this one. It's crazy. Oh, chain lightning. No, I don't want that. I want this. Apparently it won't hurt allies. Let's just put it here just in case. Near death. About time. We'll do the sworn enemy. You are my sworn enemy. I like the way she points at him like that. And just keep up the heals because we don't have any good ones anymore. It hit. I'll see that. It'll hit him. Adair. That's what happened before. Not completely sure why. That shouldn't hit him. Anything else I can do? Nah, I don't want to do that. Yeah, just attack it. Now it doesn't show. It shouldn't def- Oh, that one was easier. Huh. As the last Magfolk falls, a tide of essence sweeps through the ether. It washes over you, and you find yourself in the memories of the Eyeless. Gain a whole lot of experience, too. The hulking creatures surround you, their sinew-wrapped skeletons clanking and screeching in the semi-darkness. Their bodies fill the air with the tang of metal and the musk of sweat. The cavern in which you stand, it looks like a cavern anyway, glows with a dim ambient light. Steel flashes as the Eyeless shift and stir. They stamp their feet and groan in rasping metallic voices. Their restless energy prickles at the back of your neck. And in the echoing rumble, you hear something familiar. It's the pounding noise from your dream, the harbinger of a terrible army. You begin to wonder how many Eyeless are crowded around you. You suspect that there must be scores of them, maybe more, It's difficult to tell how far back this chamber goes, or where it is. Ahead, you can see a glint of light. It might be an exit. Already, however, the vision is starting to fade. So you only have a chance to do one thing? Explore further into the chamber or investigate the glint of light. Let's investigate the glint of light. You push past the lumbering eyeless and cling to the wilting shreds of the vision. The light up ahead is blinding after the dark of the cave. You rush toward it even as it fades into a pale blur. You can't see where you are, but you hear a cold wind whistling through the gap, and you feel a spray of moisture sting your cheeks. Possibly coming out into the out into the world, into the sunlight, maybe through a waterfall or something like that. The vision ends, returning you to the frozen and blood-churned mud of the fort. A curse of cold clay added. The quest expires in 2 days. Hello? A Darak appears to have taken some blows. There's a purpling bruise along his temple, and his armor is dented in several places. He looks rather dazed. I'm loving this, guys. This is awesome.
Those things, they came from all sides. The delegate... No, you were right. The visions are true.
A Darak looks you over.
You fought well. And I'm glad to see you've come through in one piece, even if I regret the loss of my men. I'll take what's left of our forces. Those that will follow me further up the mountain. We should be prepared if... when those monsters return.
We can defeat them if we work together.
I have seen already that there is little you can't accomplish.
Adarak bows his head and turns to the road. Oh, so there's little I can't accomplish, so you're not even going to help, huh? Gee, thanks.
Do you?
These abominations stink of a god's cowardice.
The rising tide. One of Stalwart's delegates sent to parley with the Iron Flail was an Andrite dispatched from an abbey to the north to try and dissuade the Red Serrets from their course. It seemed as though the leader of the abbey, a man named Kyoto, knew how to call off the monstrous army. He mentioned that would be done in the reliquary. He also spoke of an unexpected visitor, a Tidebringer, who would take his place. From the Andrite's soul, I was able to absorb knowledge of the path to the abbey. I must travel there if I am to stop this threat. Awesome. A curse of cold clay. All across the Eastern Reach, people are being buried in graveyards and returning from the dead as vampires. Examination by locals has revealed that animancers had tampered with several gravesites prior to the burial. Local lords have released bounties for the capture of whoever is responsible. Unfortunately, the rapid spread of the events leaves many to believe that a group, not a single individual, is behind the experiments. Now, Canna is assigned, yet it says assign. If I click this, it's going to disappear. So I'm just going to leave it. Remaining 2 turns, hopefully... Hopefully he'll finish it. Hopefully it is assigned. This is true, not this. And it'll be done in 2 turns. Who shall we assign for this one? It would be cool if I can move that around and look at it again. See, Khan is available. She makes me think he really is not assigned. Let's assign the Grieving Mother. Okay, now it says recall. Okay. I don't know why it says that. Why it acts like that. J for journal. Uh, find out how to call off the army. One of the stalwart delegates was a fanatical worshipper of Andra, who killed herself before she could provide answers. I learned from her soul that she came from the Abbey of the Fallen Moon, and that the abbot there knows if the army is able to call it off from a place he called the Reliquary. If I can reach the room, I may be able to stop an invasion before it begins. The abbot also mentioned that someone called a Tidebringer would be coming to replace him. That information could prove useful in infiltrating the place. Hmm. And she also wants to go this thing. Maneha also wants to go to the abbey for her own quest. Alright, this is the dragon thing, and yeah. And that I can't do, and that's the kid. Not giving the kid a knife. Yeah, that's it. We have only the main quest to accomplish.
Indeed.
I'm glad you agree.
Sure.
Well, it's like killed everybody here. Abbey of the Fallen Moon. Cool. Oh, I'm back outside. Yeah, I'm all the way out here. And what if these two lovers are here? If I might speak with them again. Nope. They've fled. No surprise there. Alright, guys. Yeah. Looks like a good place to cut off. Next episode, The Abbey of the Fallen Moon. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Endure and enduring. Grow strong.